Good morning. My name is Frans Kok. I'm Emeritus Professor of Nutrition and Health at Wageningen University in the Netherlands. And I was a member of the organizing committee for this symposium. I'm chairing the session number one on beer in daily life, also non-alcoholic beer in daily life. And I like to invite the first speaker, which is Patricia Kupnicka. She is a PhD student from the biochemistry department of the Medical University in Stettin in Poland. Her research is focusing on elemental composition of food and changes in mineral composition of tissues in health and diseases. And today she will give a presentation and her insight into micronutrients, minerals, and polyphenols in non-alcoholic and low-alcoholic beer. May I invite Dr. Kupnicka?
Welcome. Thank you for the introduction. As Professor Kok said, my name is Patricia Kupnicka. I am a PhD student in the Department of Biochemistry at the Pomeranian Medical University in Szczecin, where lately you have been interested in health properties of beer. The health properties of alcohol are the subject of another session, and I today would like to focus on non-alcoholic beer. Let's start with the advantages of beer, not only non-alcoholic. Beer is rich in polyphenols, but it also contains amino acids, peptides, and B-group vitamins. And lower consumption of beer, moderate consumption of beer, may lower levels of homocysteine, reduce the risk of coronary heart diseases, and is associated with higher bone mineral density. Also, the melatonin contained in beer has shown antioxidant, oncostatic, and immune-enhancing activities. Beer has relatively low alcohol level, and as we all know, it's got the best taste. Our recent research in at the university was focused on the elemental composition of beer. The results we obtained in our study indicate that the composition of beer differs among countries, and that beer is a good source of calcium. 500 milliliters of beer covers up to 15.5% of daily needs. The rest of the studied elements, chlorine, potassium, and phosphorus, are covered up in 3%. And the richest source of calcium was German beer, and the richest source of potassium and phosphorus was Portuguese beer. Considering microelements, the conclusions are similar to those regarding macroelements. The composition also differed among countries. And the richest source of iron, zinc, and copper was Ukrainian beer. The composition differs most likely because of the water used in the process and the conditions of grain cultivation. Our research was focused on lager and pils beers, but I hope in the future we can study also craft beers, because I am a huge fan of craft beers, and I hope their composition differs from regular beer, and hopefully they also have a higher antioxidant potency, but we will see in the future. Comparing non-alcoholic beer or low-alcohol beer with regular beer, there are no great differences. Low-alcohol beer has less calories and less sugars, but they are still present. We have to remember to consume beverages with sugars in moderation because of the risk of obesity, but in studies, the consumption of 500 milliliters of beer daily did not contribute to weight gain. Also, the traces of vitamin A were found in low-alcohol beer, and also the concentration of niacin was higher in low-alcohol beer. The concentration of B group vitamins was similar in both kinds of beer. And interestingly, the levels of phosphorus and magnesium were higher in regular beer. And the level of sodium was higher in low alcohol beer. Even though beer has macro and micronutrients, it cannot be a substitute for a healthy and balanced diet. And drinking too much alcohol can lead to increased calorie intake, high blood pressure, heart failure, and stroke. The main ingredients of beer are water, malt, and hops. Malt is germinated cereal grains that have been, dried in a malting process. About 75% of minerals in beer come from the malt, and I think silicon is the one worth mentioning here. After drinking beer, serum and urinary levels of silicon increase significantly, confirming that beer is readily bioavailable source of silicon. Hops contain substantially more silicon than cereals, but quantitatively, hops make a much smaller contribution to beer than hops. And silicon plays an important role in bone formation and bone and connective tissue health. Also, 80 to 90% of polyphenols come from the malt. Ferulic and picumaric acids have shown a high neuroprotective role and can be considered as anti-Alzheimer's disease agents. Malt also triggers a prolactin response resulting in a lactogenic effect. Beer is the only beverage that contains hops, flowers of the hop plant. Hops are a very rich source of polyphenols, including alpha acids, beta acids, and flavonoids. It also contains essential oils, which combined with bitter acids give our beer its flavor and aroma. One of the flavonoids found in beer is xanthohumol, which is currently under research for its potential chemopreventive and antirestenotic properties. Hops also have a sedative and anxiolytic effect. The brewing process of non-alcoholic brews is the same as that of the traditional brews. After maturation, brew can be converted to non-alcoholic beer. Some nutrients and chemical compounds are surely lost during alcohol removal process, but most of them are preserved. And the addition of extra water may contribute to change levels of some elements found in beer. As we can see in the table, polyphenols are indeed present in non-alcoholic beer, and they are 1/3 of the quantity of polyphenols found in hops extract. Large amounts of alcohol may contribute to weight gain, abdominal obesity, and hypertension. Risk factors of metabolic syndrome. Non-alcoholic beer may be then a safer choice for people with atherosclerosis risk, and non-alcoholic beer is a great alternative to those who do not want to consume alcohol but still love beer. The studies concerning the effect of non-alcoholic beer consumption on health are limited, but the number is still growing. Scientists analyzed the effect of pre- and post-exercise consumption of different kinds of beer on the hydration level after exercise. I know it's the topic of the next presentation, so I won't steal any thunder here. I would just say that there may be some effects of beer, also non-alcoholic, mainly non-alcoholic, I think, that could help to maintain blood electrolyte level during exercise. Hops have sedative and anxiolytic properties, mostly because of containing bitter acids, xanthohumol and myrcenol. In the study conducted by Franco and others, drinking non-alcoholic beer with dinner for 14 days statistically reduced sleep latency and decrease the sleep disorders. Sleep loss and therefore increased daytime sleepiness have a negative effect on vigilance, memory, language and cognitive and academic results. And in light of those facts, the scientists concluded that drinking non-alcoholic beer at dinner is recommended, especially in a population under high stress. In similar study conducted by the same team, but among different population, the researchers also found a reduction in sleep latency, and they also found a reduction in nocturnal mobility, which resulted in an improvement in the quality of nighttime sleep and the restful sleep, which reflected in decreased anxiety among healthy female nurses. Besides hops, also lysine containing beer has an anxiolytic effect. After drinking non-alcoholic beer for 14 days, participants completed tests that measured their anxiety levels, and the results they obtained after non-alcoholic beer treatment were statistically lower than those obtained before the trial. Also, the levels of serotonin metabolite were statistically lower after non-alcoholic beer treatment, and therefore the scientists concluded that the population enrolled with stress after drinking non-alcoholic beer improves their anxiolytic response through the serotonergic pathway. Polyphenols found in beer are known for their cardioprotective properties. In their study, Chiva Blanche and others found that moderate alcoholic and non-alcoholic beer consumption enhanced the number of circulating endothelial progenitor cells in high cardiovascular risk subjects. EPC have the ability to repair endothelial damage as well as contribute to the angiogenic process. Researchers observed also an increase in EPC mobilizing agent after non-alcoholic beer intervention. Therefore, the increased number of EPC after non-alcoholic beer consumption should be attributed to an enhanced survival in the circulation. The effects of alcoholic regular beer and non-alcoholic beer were similar, and ethanol by itself did not seem to have an effect on EPC number because there was no statistical significance. Therefore, the scientists concluded that non-alcoholic fraction of beer is responsible for observed effects, and the increased number of circulating EPC is associated with reduced cardiovascular risk, giving the results obtained in this study a potential clinical significance. The main beer constituents derived from hops are isohamulones, which confer the bitter taste of beer. These compounds activate intranuclear transcription factors, peroxisome proliferator activated receptor, which regulate the expression of many genes with important physiological functions. Ligands of this receptor has been used to treat hyperlipidemia and diabetes. Isohamulones given to mice with type 2 diabetes significantly decreased plasma glucose, triglyceride, and free fatty acid levels. They also decreased the size of hypertrophic adipocytes. The capsules given to patients with mild diabetes decreased their plasma glucose and HbA1c levels and the systolic blood pressure. The administration of isohamulones increased also the blood level of HDL cholesterol, known as the good cholesterol, and lowered the atherogenic index, and decreased the content of cholesterol and triglycerides in the liver. Because of its composition, beer may demonstrate antioxidative potential. A study from 2013 showed that non-alcoholic beer increases the antioxidant properties of breast milk and decreases the oxidative damage in breastfeeding mothers. Firstly, I would like to emphasize that drinking alcohol during pregnancy or breastfeeding is never advisable because of the degenerative effect of alcohol on developing nervous system and the risk of fetal alcohol syndrome. In this study, the researchers studied the differences between colostrum and mature milk. They presented that drinking non-alcoholic beer improves the decrease observed, improves the decrease in total antioxidant capacity observed from colostrum to mature milk. They also observed that the levels of coenzyme Q10 did not drop in the study group, unlike in the control group. Drinking non-alcoholic beer also caused a decrease in oxidative damage to biomolecules, mainly DNA in mother's plasma, and it did not affect the biomarkers of oxidative status in the urine of both the mother or infant. Another study conducted on animals showed the neuroprotective effects of non-alcoholic beer, silicon, and hop extract. Silicon is widely known component of beer, and besides its effect on bone homeostasis, it helps to re-establish mineral balance in the brain. As we can see in the table, the studied solutions are able to partially inhibit acetylcholine esterase. Lower levels of acetylcholine esterase contribute to higher levels of acetylcholine, which is an important neurotransmitter in learning and memory. The greatest inhibition was observed in the silicon group, and because non-alcoholic beer group was characterized by higher inhibition level than hops extract group, it might be concluded that silicon present in beer is responsible for observed effects. In this study, the researchers also found that non-alcoholic beer, hops extract, and silicon treatment appear to prevent aluminum-induced augmented lipid peroxidation and changes the levels of endogenous antioxidants, probably by contributing antioxidants or modulating antioxidant enzyme expression. The administration of silicon and non-alcoholic beer restored the values of NRF2 to control values, while hops produce a multifold increase, and the inhibition of TBARS strongly suggests the neuroprotective properties of silicon and beer compounds against aluminum intoxication. Therefore, the studied substances are able to arrest the negative effect of aluminum intoxication and counteract neurodegenerative effects induced by aluminum nitrate. The studies in the area of non-alcoholic beer are unfortunately limited. Based on data published so far, we can say that drinking non-alcoholic beer at dinner improves sleep quality, decreases anxiety, and is recommended in a population under high stress. Isohamolans contained in beer may improve lipid metabolism and improve insulin resistance. Non-alcoholic beer counteracts the neurodegenerative effect induced by heavy metals present in the environment. Non-alcoholic beer has antioxidant potency and may enhance the antioxidant properties of human milk and help mothers to decrease their oxidative status after delivery. And non-alcoholic beer has greater cardioprotective effect compared to distilled alcoholic beverages in high cardiovascular risk population. Thank you for your attention, and I think we can now clearly say that Sting was drinking beer while creating the song Fields of Gold.